What is going on, people? It's Eternal Prince here, bringing you another episode of ARK Survival Evolved. So now, guys, what we discussed on the last episode was I was going to be picking one random name from what you guys commented in the comment section for our first dodo. So I'm just going to move this microphone out of the way. So how we're going to do this is basically we've got our hat here. This is our famous live streaming hat. So we've done all sorts in this in Red Dead Redemption and whatnot on Twitch. So I've put all the names into the hat, and moving forward we're going to be adding, so all the comments on episode 2 will be added into this hat in terms of names, and we're going to be using this hopefully to name all the creatures that we capture. So just by random I'll go pick out a name out of the hat, and I've got one right here, and this one is going to be the mole. Danny Dorba by Sir Breezy. And obviously, guys, this is picked by random as well. So there you have it. Our first dodo will be called Danny Dorba the Dodo by Sir Breezy. Thank you, Sir Breezy. So, guys, keep the comments flowing in. And if you haven't yet, come and join our private server. So all the links and description, all the links and whatnot are in the description below. So yeah, so come and join the Discord and you'll find out all the information that you need to find out. Okay guys, without much further ado, let's get straight into this episode. So in this episode I really want to be focusing on our building, so hopefully we're not dead. Yes, we've not died. So let's go put our trick up, and there we have it. We can see now a lot better. Now I put out something down here. There we have it. It's still here. This is our sleeping bag and whatnot, and a campfire too. So what I want to base this episode off is, we could do with some clothes, but what we're going to do is I'm going to base it off building a small little base, just because I feel like we need to shelter ourselves from the elements, and yeah, hopefully let's see if we can do this. So we've got Eternal Smogle over here. And we are quite cold. We haven't got any clothes, so I want to start making a house. I don't know if you guys have ever seen those videos on like Instagram or Facebook where those you see those like tribes people building like swimming pools or building a base. This is how we want to do it. So we press I, we go to Engram points, and I want to start making my house. And we need to do that, we need a foundation. So I'm just going to unlock that. So once we've got the foundation, we're going to need some walls. And then we're going to need some ceilings. We're going to need a door frame. And we're going to need a thatch door. And quite possibly a storage box as well. So I'll carry on building that. And then what we'll do is we'll go ahead and do that. So to make our foundations, which we've already got some items, we need, if I can just load this up, let's make these two first. We're going to be needing, I don't know why the pop-ups are not coming up. Why are the pop-ups not coming up? This is not good. We've also got a level up too. Well, guys, that's a good start that was. So basically, we need to see why our pop-ups are not coming up. And I reckon it's because settings being turned off for some strange reason. We could have a quick look over here. No tooltip delay. There we go. That should do it nicely. So let's go here, let's go back to I, and come on, why are you not coming up? ARK, please don't do this to me, please. Why are you not doing this? Right, it might just be a case of just farming a few more items and just be able to see. So we're going to get some thatch, we're going to get some wood. Okay, we've got quite a bit of wood now. We've got quite a bit of thatch too. Ignore that whistle. I want to know why I can't see you. Let's have a look. Okay, so we can go the other way. So if we go to Engram points, we can actually have a look and see. So we need 15 fiber, 20 thatch, and 6 wood, which we've got quite a bit of. So we just need to get some fiber now. And a load of berries as well. So if we get hungry, we'll do that too. So let's get our fiber together. Got over 100 fiber now. That should be more than enough. Now, it depends on how we want to build our base. I reckon we should go by laying one foundation out and then working out what we need to do. So let's go out. Let's craft all the rest of these six. So while that's crafting, I can go ahead and get my foundation out. And then what we can do is we can right click and place. So we could probably start placing our foundation here like this. I reckon something like this. And then you can also rotate as you need to. I'm just going to get rid of that level up as well. So let's put one down. And then if you just right click off, and then if we go to levels quickly, we can go put another level in. So I didn't really explain this in the last game, but I like to put my levels into weight and movement speed, preferably. Everyone's different. But for weight, just so I can carry more, just convenience. I'm going to go and put two levels into weight, and then we're just going to back out. And now that we've made the rest of our foundations, I think I'm going to go ahead and place the rest of them. So you've got a choice. You can either do a 2x2, like that, and make a box. Or what I'm feeling is I'm feeling a kind of like a 2x4. 2x4 would be just nice, I think. So what we need to do is we've got our foundations down. We need to go ahead and start making some walls. And to make some walls, we can actually, if we go back over to Engram Points, we can have a look. So normally it should be coming up over here, and I don't know why it's not. If anyone could explain that, I'd appreciate that. Let me know in the comments section. I don't know why this isn't coming up, and I'm quite sad. But yeah, let's go over to Engram Points, and then we can go over to the thatch wall. And what we need is we need fiber, wood, and thatch. So we've got wood, we've got fiber, we just need some thatch, I think. So let's go ahead and get our pickaxe out, and start hitting this tree. This tree or any other tree. I've also got another level up too, nice. We keep hitting this, we'll get all the thatch that we need. And I just want to put a point into the level up. Let's do that quickly. So now we've got a carry weight level of 200. Up to 200. So that should be good. So obviously when you start reaching closer to like the 200 mark, your character will start slowing down. So that's not good. We don't want that. We want to avoid that as much as possible. So let's get the rest of this fiber out. Okay, there's like some fiber like trapped inside that stone for some reason. Not to worry though. So let's go ahead and pick the rest of this fiber up if I can. Sometimes it's better to go into first person. It's just easier. But we've got more than enough now. So we need two walls. 4 plus 4 plus 2, 10, 11. We'll need 11 walls. So let's go over here and make 11 walls. So we've got, we can make up to 16. Nice. Let's go ahead and make 11. And then we also need to make a door frame. So let's go ahead and craft one, two. And then we need a door. And now we're going to need a load of ceilings as well. So, yeah, let's place our walls first before we do anything else. In the meantime, what I might do is I might start eating some berries. So our food is quite low. So what we can do is we can actually go ahead and, once again, put them in order like I said last time, and then just hold E, and we can eat all these berries over here, hopefully. Our hunger will slowly start going up. That should be more than enough. So what we can do here is we can go ahead and start placing these walls now, and it should just snap into place. So let's go here and go on the outskirts first. Sometimes you might need to jiggle between third person and first person. I said jiggle, but I meant juggle. So let's go ahead and start placing these walls. There we have it. Also, remember, we've got the fireplace outside. We've got the sleeping bag too, so we'll have to make a bed eventually in this house. But we can get to that. Not a problem. There we have it. So now we've placed all the walls. We should go ahead and place this door frame. Oh, so that's why I had toggle tool tips off. So if you ever have that issue, guys, that's what it's going to be. So yeah, guys, we've got the thatch door frame. Let's go ahead and place this. And last but not least, we've got the door. So let's go ahead and place this door too. Oh, why are you all the way up there? Boom. There we have it. And then eat it open. And then all we need to do is we need to go craft some roof, which we'll need 8 pieces, I think. So we've got 2 there already. We're going to need a bit of thatch and we're going to need a bit of wood too. So let's go ahead and start getting this together while we make the rest of our roof. So there's our thatch. We should just be able to chop this up too. Let's go ahead down here, get the rest of this wood too and the thatch. So remember, guys, pickaxe for thatch. And then your hatchet for wood. Nice and easy. So we've got more than enough thatch and wood now, so we need to go ahead and get the rest of this fiber together. So currently where we are right now, thatch will do us all right, but we should be looking to upgrade this thatch as soon as possible, and that's because dinosaurs in this world are quite aggressive and they can break down the thatch quite easily. I'm hoping it'll happen in this episode. I can show you what to do to counter it, but if it doesn't, I'm sure it will happen eventually. So I'm going to go ahead and make the rest of these over here. So we need 6 more. Crafting amount, let's go for 6. So while that's making, I can place the rest of the actual ceilings. So what we'll do is we'll shut this door behind us and start placing the ceiling. There we have it. Nice. Got 2 more coming over here as well. So when I play ARK, I like to make my ceilings a bit higher. But I guess just to illustrate this purpose right now, it's okay. We've got what we needed to get. We've got our foundations laid and we've got our walls up. So I think the best thing to make in this house, first thing that we should be making really, is a simple bed. There we have it. So let's get the simple bed out. We can go ahead and make that. And what we need for a simple bed is some hide, which should work wondrously. And I also think it's time to probably start taming that dodo that I promised you guys. So what we're going to need to tame a dodo is we're going to need a club. You guys will see why we need a club. So I'm going to go ahead and make one. And now that's made, I can go and add that to my bar over here. And yeah, we are lacking in hide for our bed, but we can get that. So I want to go find a dodo now. There also was a really big dinosaur over here in the last episode, but it's not here anymore. And I've not been playing for about 2 days, so I don't know what's happened. So we've just got to keep an eye out and be aware and make sure there's nothing else around us. And also, we could probably check who's in our private server right now. So let's go type in hi. Oh, how cute. These things are so cute. So what we are looking for right now, guys, is we are looking for a dodo. Ah, nice. It's our buddy Sir Breezy over here. Nice, nice, nice. That dinosaur's quite aggressive over there. There we go, guys. Here's our dodo. Mr. Dodo, I want you. No, I don't want to punch you, sorry. I didn't mean to do that. I apologize. It's running away from me. Oh, God, I don't want to craft that. I want to just put that into my bar, sorry. I messed up. Where's he gone? He's just gone into... Oh, there he is. Okay. So you just managed to climb up a rock. Right, Dodo, you're mine. Die. So what I'm doing is I'm using the club to knock it out. And you guys will see why I'm knocking it out. And there we go, guys. We managed to knock it out. So if I put that away, what we got here? So look at that, guys. So we've got an unconscious bar and we need to put food in the inventory to tame it. So let's go ahead and put these blueberries in there. And as you guys can see, the torpidity is going down. And when that goes down, it'll wake up. But in that meantime, we've got the taming up to a certain part. Excuse me. And yeah, the taming is going up faster than the unconscious level, which is excellent. So guys, as promised, here's this piece of paper. We've got Danny Dorba by Sir Breezy. So let's go, guys. Danny Dorba, the dodo. Boom! We've caught our first dodo, guys. So you can control these dodos by doing certain actions. So for example, I can press J. And J means that it should start following me. Come on. Come on. Come on, Danny. So it's going to start following me now. And I want to take this guy back to base with me. So let's go ahead and take him back to the base. Come on, boy. Come on, Danny. Yeah, I think we can just keep going and it should, in theory, follow us all the way back to the base. Come on. There's a parasaur over there. Look at that. We'll come and get you another episode, mate. Come on, Danny. Hurry up. So one thing I didn't explain in the last episode was that we could actually go ahead and cook some meat as well. Which I'll probably show you guys. Oh, sugar. The dodo was killed. Danny Dorba, the dodo, was killed by a pegasaur. That's not good. So that means that we're going to need to go and catch another one. I don't know where this pegasaur is, and now I'm kind of worried. I don't want to die. I'm that worried that my character is pooing. So this is like probably the best example to show you guys. Like, I know we're going to be catching all sorts, but we can't get too attached to what we catch. When we start getting attached, we're going to worry. Oh, guys, look, we've got a triceratops here. Nice. Triceratops, what level are you? Level 25. Nice. Right, we need to find another dodo from somewhere. I don't know how we're going to do that. There's a dodo over there. I just saw it here. I mean, there it is. Right, come on, boy. Over here. So this one's even a higher level. So just try and knock it out with your club. Once it's been knocked down, go ahead and go to its inventory and feed it some berries. Oh my god. Okay, something's hitting me now. Something took my thatch. Yeah, so you'll get random dinosaurs like trying to steal your thatch. I'm hoping it doesn't come back. I don't know where it's gone. Okay, it doesn't like these berries. What we can do is we can add this berry over here. These ones are quite tasty, the ones I just put in there. I'll go ahead and eat this as well, why not? I'll eat the rest of these while we're waiting. Name your dodo. Danny Dorba the Dodo 2. Or, you know, I just put 1. We'll just take that as a learning curve, and then I'll level up into weight 2. Right, come on, Danny. Let's go. Second time. I'm going to try and defend you as best I can now. We're not going to be messing about. Come on. Oh, it's so cute, guys. Look at it. Look at it run towards us. Come on. Come on, boy. So something killed it, but I'm going to try and stay nearby now. So if something does attack, we're going to at least try and fight it off. Because normally when you try and fight a dinosaur off... Oh, shit, there it is. So yeah, guys, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to get the hide from this. We're going to use our pickaxe for that. Also, it had an inventory as well. I'll take the berries back. Thank you very much, Danny Dorba. Come on. Should be safe, but I don't see any dinosaurs. Come on, Danny. Come on. Come on, Danny. Come on, boy. Right, Mr. Dorba. If you just want to park your butt here. So, To get them to stop following you, what you can do is you can press U. And then if you go towards this, you can hold E onto the dodo, and then you can tell it to do certain things like harvest. You can tell it to just flee. Yeah. So you can do all sorts with it. So we've got a bit of hide. Is it enough to make our bed? Not enough. So we need to go and kill some more stuff. What I will say is that dinosaurs can attack your dinosaurs, your dodos. So just be on the guard, make sure there's nothing nearby. If there is, get it killed. And obviously, this is the PvP server, guys, so it's open to everyone for all of you guys to join. And yeah, it'd be much better to play in a private server rather than a public server, because you've got more chance of surviving, if I'm being completely honest. And more space to build too, especially. So what we want to do is we want to try and find something that we can kill, which there was quite a lot of stuff here before, but it's not here anymore. But these things are quite good as well. I don't think they fight back. Holy sugar. Yep, so you don't fight these guys here. Really? I took my berries. They're just basically just thieves. So what we're going to do is we're going to try and kill it. Just for trying to take my stuff. Flying dinosaur too. Piece of... I think this was what killed my dodo. We're not going to let it slide. We'll try and kill what we can. Look, so it's turning red, guys. That means it's dying. There we have it, guys. Got all my stuff back too, hopefully. Let's get the meat out. And let's get the hide out too. And I'm going to start running back to base. I think that should be enough to make our bed. So let's go into crafting. We've got enough hide. We just need to get some thatch together. So let's do that. I think that was what killed my dodo. So annoying. So who knows, guys. In episode 3 we might log in and it might be dead, the dodo. But you can do stuff about that. But it's kind of difficult. So I've just made my bed. So we added the simple bed into that. And then what I can do here is do the level up first. I can go ahead and place this bed over here. So the beauty of placing a bed is that now that I'm going to die, or if I die, I can choose to spawn at this bed or at a sleeping bag. So sleeping bags are like single use. But the beds are permanent fast travel points, so I can put one here, and then for argument's sake I can go to the map and put one, well, I don't know why the red marker's there, but anywhere in the map, and I can go ahead and travel. So another thing I wanted to show you guys was I'm kind of sick of eating berries, if I'm being completely honest. They don't fill me up, as you can see. What we can do instead is we can go ahead and light this fire. Ooh. Got some spoiled meat here too. But yeah, we can put some wood into this campfire to get it started. So we put this campfire down last time. And then now what we can do is we can actually go ahead and put this meat alongside the wood. And then if we light the fire, and then we've come back to it in 30 seconds, you'll see something a bit different. How you doing, Danny? How are you? You okay? I don't know if they actually do react with you. I don't know what neuter means. But you can like change the name, you can unclaim it, you can export the dino. So yeah, guys, if you do want your name, if you want to be named after this, or if you want one of your names to be picked on this one too, then feel free to do that. So if we come over here, access to the inventory. There we have it, guys. We've got some cooked meat. We can go ahead and put that into our inventory. And then what I like to do is, I like to put this onto my bar. And there we have it, guys. We've got a food source now, other than berries. Now, I think you could probably end up, like, making stews and whatnot. But, oh, we've got a parasaur, and I do really want it. But we're not ready for it just quite yet. What level are you? Level 10, so it's not that high of a level, but I'm sure we can find a high enough level, should I say. So, just out of the fun of it, guys, I'm going to see if I can go and get another dodo for us, guys. And we're going to name it something else out of the hat. So, let's go over here. We've got a trike over there. Ideally, what I want to do is I want to be able to have, like, one of each dinosaur. We're not quite ready for the big stuff just yet. I'm tired. You should stop moving to regain your stamina. Yeah, sure. So, I'm going to see if I could go ahead and find myself another dodo from somewhere. Usually when you kill one or two, that another one will spawn somewhere nearby. Or after a few minutes or whatnot. So, I've not seen another dodo just yet, which I'm quite sad about. But there should be quite a few scattered around this area, you know, because it's a beginner's area and dodos are like beginner creatures. Server's playing up. Come on, server. Yeah, I reckon we can go up here and we'll find something. But I don't want to go too deep, you see, because bad things happen when you go deep. So what we need to be looking for is we need to be looking for something that we can tame. There are all these other little dinosaurs as well, and I can't see them either, so I don't know what's happened. There's that guy. There's another Triceratops. What level are you? Level 120! No way! Some of these are really high level. There we go, Mr. Dodo. Come over here. I've got some food for you. I've got some treats. So guys, just out of for the fun of this one, we're going to go ahead and feed this guy some berries. And while we're feeding the berries, I'm going to go ahead and pick one more hat out of the name. So, there we go. Let's go ahead and pick one out. And we've got one here. And this one's going to be... Drum roll! Haha! We've got a Shanky Mitsu. By Shanky Devil. Shanky Mitsu by Shanky Devil. So once this dodo wakes up, I'll be naming it Shanky Mitsu. Shout out to Shanky Mitsu, aka Shanky Devil. Shanky Mitsu. Right, come on then. Come on, Dodo. Come on, Shanky. So, you can also control the creatures by doing certain things like this, look. So if you hold T, you can tell them to come further. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to change this, the following distance that they do. So change the follow distance to lowest. So now it should literally just be right next to me at all times. There's no way we're going to lose him. So, yeah, guys, so in this episode, you've learned how to build a house and you've learned how to tame your first creatures. I know it's a dodo, but we'll get to the bigger and more fun stuff at some point in the next few episodes. I want to get myself a parasol. I want to get myself clothed. We are dehydrated, so I'm going to stop off at the river to drink some water. And then I'm going to start making my way back to base. Right. Awesome. So let's go ahead and make a spear, because we haven't got a spear, so let's just press 3 over there. Come on, Danny. Come on, Shanky. Here we go, guys. Let's keep this going. I'm going to make sure that the path is clear. Just out of curiosity, guys, I'm going to see if I can feed one of these. I don't even know what that is. Put taming food in the last item slot to feed. We'll work on that another time. Doesn't matter. Come on. Come on, Shanky. Right, you know what, guys? I'm just going to run all the way back to base. If Shanky Mitsu dies, it is what it is. I'm hoping my dinos will... my dodos will be safe. So, yeah, we can go back to this fire now. Go back to the inventory, and in theory, our stuff is all here. Nice. So we've got quite a bit of food now. We've got quite a bit of water. We are quite hungry though. Let's have a look at our inventory over here. Need a bit of food and we need a bit of water. So let's go and hit 9. 9 again. And then, yeah, you guys stop there. So we've got Danny Adorba and we've got Shanky Mitsu. So, you guys, thank you so much to everyone who tuned in today. If you guys... Oh, my God, there's a dinosaur here. We need to go deal with this guy. Otherwise, he's going to try and kill us. Normally, they attack. Sugar! That's what we didn't want. They've poisoned us. It's fine. So what these guys do is they tend to spit out a venom. They spit out a venom which can blind you and poison you. Luckily, we managed to control ourselves. But I don't know if you guys saw what just happened. The dinosaur attacked me, and the dodos defended. That's what we like. So I'm just gonna go ahead and harvest the rest of this. Stupid dinosaurs. I hate those guys, man. They're so annoying. But yeah, that's how you defend yourself, and you need to make sure your area is clear. And later on in the game, you can get defensible items. But yeah, guys, that's the episode done. What a way to finish the episode. So if you like what you guys see, remember to give the video a thumbs up. And don't forget to drop a comment with the next name in the comment section. And come and join the Discord. Peace.